Solvent extraction. Solvent extraction, also known as liquid extraction, is a separation technique. It can be used to transfer an analyte from one liquid phase to another liquid phase in contact with it. It is based on the relative solubility of an analyte in two immiscible or partially miscible liquids, one of which is usually an aqueous solution and the other is an organic solvent. Let's take a closer look at the miscibility of two common solvent pairs. One pair is dichloromethane and water, and the other pair is diethyl ether and water. The miscibility chart shows us that dichloromethane and water are immiscible. Ether is also immiscible with water. The target analyte partitions between two liquid phases to establish equilibrium. The extraction efficiency depends on the partition ratio, also known as the distribution constant. The partition ratio is the ratio of the concentration of an analyte in a single defined form in an organic phase to its concentration in the same form in the aqueous phase at equilibrium. The equation relates to an organic aqueous system where the aqueous phase forms the feed. Solvent extraction includes 9 steps. There are important things to remember about these steps. First, the stopper and the plug of the stopcock must be well fitted to prevent leakage of solution. Next, a separatory funnel should never be more than 3/4 full. And then, the funnel should not be shaken too vigorously because it may cause formation of emulsion. An emulsion is the dispersion of droplets in an immiscible liquid. If an emulsion has formed near the interface between two liquid layers, we could wait for a few minutes to see if separation will occur on its own. Sometimes gentle swirling and stirring is enough to destroy it. Another method is to add brine or salt water to the solution. It will increase the density of the aqueous layer, thereby forcing separation. And it will help break the emulsion. Then we need to know which layer is organic and which one is aqueous. The layers can be identified using a simple technique, as demonstrated later in this video. Only the bottom layer should be drained through the stopcock. This allows us to minimize contamination as only one layer touches the stem of the SEP funnel. Usually, the solution containing the solid is extracted 3 times with fresh portions of the extraction solvent. After separation of the organic and the aqueous layers, the organic layer will be wet. It will contain water. Water can be removed from the organic layer by treating it with a suitable desiccant. Desiccants are drying agents that absorb water due to their chemical and physical properties. The 2 common types of desiccants are zeolite molecular sieves types A and X and anhydrous inorganic salts such as magnesium sulfate and sodium sulfate. Desiccants have varying properties and applications. Not all desiccants can absorb the same amount of water and can dry an organic layer to the same extent. Capacity is the amount of water a desiccant will absorb per its weight. Completeness is the effectiveness of a desiccant in removing all the water from an organic layer by the time equilibrium has been established. And rate is the rate of drying. For example, zeolites, also commonly known as molecular sieves, have high capacity and extremely high completeness.
Zeolites are aluminosilicate minerals that can carry water. Zeolites are made up of tetrahedral built-in units. Their pore openings are used to absorb molecules smaller than the pore size and reject molecules larger than the pore size. It is important to select the right zeolite for a given application. Type A zeolites have distinct capabilities of adsorption, whereas type X offer much larger pore openings than type A. For example, 4A molecular sieve has a pore opening of approximately 4 angstroms. If the sodium ion is exchanged with a larger potassium ion, the pore opening is reduced to 3 angstroms. On ion exchange with calcium, the pore opening increases to 5 angstroms. Type 13X is a sodium modified molecular sieve with a pore diameter of 10 angstroms. For example, type 4A molecular sieve is suitable for drying diethyl ether, since the pore size excludes the entry of ether but does not exclude the entry of water. Anhydrous inorganic salts such as magnesium sulfate and sodium sulfate are suitable for general purpose applications, including drying ether layer. These salts can absorb a large amount of water. Although magnesium sulfate is faster and can dry an organic layer more completely, it is slightly acidic. So, for example, it works well in diethyl ether, but not as well for ethyl acetate. As for sodium sulfate, it works well for both solvents. Although sodium sulfate will not free an organic layer completely of water, it has been considered the best of salt desiccants. Once the drying task is complete, the desiccant should be removed by gravity filtration.
Using a separation funnel is a good way to extract and wash organic products. To set up, you will need the following: a retort stand with a retort ring, a separation funnel of appropriate size with a lid that fits tightly, a waste beaker, a collection flask,
and a conical flask.
Once you have these and the setup is shown, you are ready to start using the separation funnel. Carefully add your liquid to the funnel, making sure not to fill it over halfway. Now you can add the other liquid. If the method wants you to extract, you will need to use an organic solvent. If it wants you to wash, add water. In this case, I wish to extract, so I put in an organic solvent. Now you can place the cap on and give it a slight twist to secure it. Place the cap to the palm of your hand and point the tip of the separation funnel to the back of the fume hood. Using a rocking motion, move the separation funnel and at regular intervals release the valve to release pressure. Continue to do this until you cannot hear the sound of pressure releasing. Now return it to the ring and remove the lid. Wait until you can clearly see the separation between the layers. Now you need to collect your sample. The liquids are separated based on density, so the highest density will be on the bottom. In this case, DCM was used, which has a higher density than water, so the product is on the bottom. Place the collection flask under the funnel and carefully open the valve to let the liquid out, making sure to stop it just before the boundary between the layers as to not contaminate your product. The remaining liquid
is raffinate. The extraction steps can be repeated twice or more times with fresh solvent to ensure complete extraction. The top layer should be removed through the top of the funnel. It is best to keep both layers until the analyte of interest has been isolated.
If you're not sure whether the aqueous layer is above or below the organic layer, add a few drops of millicube water. The water droplets may enter either the top layer or the bottom layer. In any case, shall enter the aqueous layer. For example, since the densities of halogenated organic solvents such as DCM are higher than that of water, DCM will rest on the bottom, and the water layer will be above it. So the water droplets will mix with the top layer. The densities of non-halogenated organic solvents such as diethyl ether are lower than that of water, so a non-halogenated solvent like ether will float on top of the aqueous layer. We can see that the water droplets falling through the upper layer into the lower layer. This means that the aqueous layer is below the organic layer. After extraction, it's essential to remove the residual water from the organic layer by adding the proper desiccant. We are going to add sodium sulfate in small amounts, because adding too much will cause absorption of our product and may also lead to its loss. After adding a small amount, swirl the mixture in the flask. We can see the sodium sulfate clumps together, sticking to the bottom of the flask. Since the majority of the sodium sulfate has clumped, we need to add a bit more. Now, the desiccant swirls loosely when the flask is shaken. It's not clumped. We want to let it set for 10 minutes to make sure that all the water is absorbed out of an organic layer. The solution will become clear when it is dry. To remove the desiccant, we should perform a gravity filtration through fluted filter paper. Then, ideally, we need to rinse the desiccant 3 times with a minimum amount of dry solvent, adding each of these rinses to the flask. At the end of the extraction, we have our compound of interest dissolved exclusively in the organic solvent.